I'm Matt Powell from the Solidworks training team. This is the first video in the series titled Beginner's Guide to xShape. I'm going to be walking you through brief tutorials where I create different components on xShape. In this video, we'll be creating a simple chair to help you get familiar with the user interface and some of the commands on xShape. Each video in this playlist will cover a different component and increase in complexity. Let's jump into xShape and get started. For this series, I'll assume you already have a 3D Experience account and know how to navigate and save to the platform. Once I start the xShape app, I'll click New Component to get started. I'll enter a name for the component, a collaborative space to store the file, and optionally, I'll add a bookmark that I created ahead of time. Once I click OK, you can see the user interface of xShape. The Design Manager is on the left. Everything we create will be shown here. On the bottom is the action bar. We'll be focusing on the subdivision tab. On the top right is the reference triad. We can use the reference triad to help orient our view. And the arrow next to the triad opens a context toolbar with additional tools. I'll be using SolidWorks mouse controls, which you can change by clicking on your profile image, preferences, mouse control. To start creating our chair, I'll activate box and drop it at the center by clicking on the X. The boxes shown in the work area controls the number of segments in the X, Y, and Z direction. The icons allow you to quickly know what each box controls. To begin the chair, we'll change the number of segments in the Z direction to 1, and we'll use the arrow to change the height. I'll drag my mouse to the ruler and snap it to 35. Set the box to mid-plane, and click the green check to confirm. You can see that the box is still highlighted and the robot appears. We'll go over the robot a little later in the video. For now, I'll click on an empty space in the work area to remove my selection. If you ever want to learn more about a command, you can hover over the command and click More Help. Now, I'll start adding material using the extrude command. Throughout the video, I'll be zooming in by scrolling the mouse wheel towards me. And I'll be zooming out by scrolling the mouse wheel away from me. I'll activate repeat selection so that the same selection will be repeated when I click Accept and Continue. This will be the last time I want to repeat my selection, so I'll toggle it off before clicking Accept and Continue. The extrude command can also be used to create a hole by selecting two faces on different sides of the mesh object. I can rotate my view by holding down my middle mouse button and dragging. I'll add the last extrudes and click the green check. I'll switch to a trimetric view and reframe the model so we can see it better. I want to resize the hole and increase the length of the legs. I'll switch my view to the YZ plane using the reference triad. And box select a section of the hole. The robot appears. The robot allows you to manipulate the position and orientation of your selection. Depending on how you want the robot to behave, there are different options available when you right-click the robot. I'll change the robot to match the XYZ coordinates as shown on the reference triad. Feel free to experiment to see what option works best for you. I'll modify the hole. I'll make the legs of the chair longer by box selecting the bottom points and using the robot to move it down. Finally, to make sure the legs will be flat on the ground, I'll activate the crease command and select the bottom faces of the legs. The crease command allows you to make the edges sharper. The higher the percentage, the sharper the crease. Set the percentage of the crease to 100. And click the green check. I'll switch to a trimetric view and reframe the component. I'll save my file. Close the component. And I'm ready to create the next component in the video series. Thanks for watching. In the next video, we'll learn how to create a donut on a plate. For more great content, click the link in the description below to access additional tips, tricks, and training courses. I'll see you in the next video.